So this is our overview of how the Scaffolding Software suite of software can integrate an interface in between all the different modules in the system. We have the iQuote system, which is the quotation management system. We have the iScaf system here, waiting for a drawing to be started. And then we have the iRent system, which is already, we've already logged into this system, and that's ready to go as well. So the first point of contact here will be iQuote, where we have a new quote to generate for a client. So we are logged into the iQuote, we click on projects, and we click on add a new project. So let's choose a project type, and we type in the project name. So we'll call this Great Scaffold Job. We'll put in an address. And we can continue completing all the details, city, suburb, project contact, and all the following details as well. We can now select an existing customer. So I just type in ABC. I can select that from our list. Special comments appear. Customer details are filled in. Select the quote type. And we specify the date required. So let's put in 3/3/21. Okay, type in the estimator. So we specify estimator. We specify the date quoted. Let's be consistent with our dates here. Select a pricing method. So of course you can select our drop-down list here of pricing methods. These, of course, can all be user-defined, these selection settings, including the sales rep as well. Should specify the date added here as well. So let's change that default as well. And we can click on Save for this quote. Then we can go into the details and specify the stage details. So we can actually click on the Edit on the stage details and add a new stage. Let's keep this simple. So stage type, area one, stage name can be main scaffold. We can now enter our manual comments in here. So we can enter in our manual text, pretty much like a word processor. Manual text. There's our macro buttons. Click OK. And then we are ready to generate a quote. So let's just click on Save now. And now we are ready to generate a quotation. So if we need to create a drawing, this is where we can use iScaf to generate the drawing. So now we are in iQuote. We can actually click on Folder, and it's actually generated a folder with the name, which is the same name as the quote number, which is quote number 1048. So it's automatically created that folder ready to go. So this is a job that we need to quote for. We can enter in the rental period, labor transport details in there, but we need a material list before we can generate this, or we need to use our tools to create the information before we can enter it in here. So we can now go to the iScaf system and start a new drawing. So we can go through this process of creating the iScaf drawing. This is not the latest version of iScaf, but the iQuote, iRent, and iScaf systems can all be integrated across the different versions. So if you have an older version of iQuote, quite often they will actually be compatible. Go through the usual setup procedure. So I might draw a short bit of scaffold here. Just click OK. And let's just quickly make a wall. And let's just make five bays. Let's make them 2.4 bays and scroll in there, or just window in to view that. And I can save this, so just quickly do some editing here and put some handrails on that side, put some handrails on that side, and then save this. So we can save this as, give it a name. So now that we have created that new folder, we just sort by the date, it will be the latest one. So 1048 is the one we need to select. And we can save our drawing in here. So we can actually say, we just call it building. And call that drawing. Okay, so we can save that. And now we can build this 3D if we wanted to. We can now save this as a 3D drawing. So you can see there it's saving it at the top there into the correct folder. And then we can generate our quote. There's our quote. Convert this to a PDF file. Edit rates, for example. So we can just say cancel there and pick an item here. Edit the rates. Let's make this that's a bit expensive, isn't it? So let's make that and just give it a weight. So we have some rates in here. So we now have a price and a weight. So that's about $60,000 of rental. So we click OK on that. And we can actually quote this. Convert it to a PDF file. So we can create a CSV file as well, and create a PDF, so there's our quotation. And the other way of exporting the quote is to click on quote and actually click on export, and that's another way of doing it as well. So specify the folder, which can be 1048, and specify the file name if we wanted to. Click save, and that's another way of exporting that file. So there we have our 3D drawing and our quotation. So that's the iScaf system. Let's go back to that quote again. Now remember that our quote was about $60,000 for the rental for a certain period of time. So let's say that's $30,000 per week. So we can actually go back here now and type in to be, say, 28 days, and let's have a day rate of 2,000 after that. The iScaf quote actually also has, you can actually enter in a transport cost, so let's make it 5,000. And 5,000 to return, and then let's not have any markup. And then the labor to erect can be 7,000, and the dismantle labor can be 5,000. And let's make that a zero markup as well. So we can save this and we can print this as a quote, many different layouts. Print layout 3. And here's our summary of our quote. It automatically calculates 4 weeks, so this is one of many different formats you can print. So there are many different templates you can use and many different ways you can customize your quotations. Of course, we can make changes, so I can double click on here and make that change again if I needed to. Need to actually press the edit button to make the change. And of course, you can actually print a summary table. And of course, you can print a summary of quotations there as well. So if you're satisfied with this, you can actually also browse the folder as well. So actually, what I didn't do was actually save the quote to a printer to a printer or save it as a PDF file. Let's make that right here. So that's our PDF file of that quote. Of course, this is just the tip of the iceberg. So now we've entered that quote in, we can now accept this as a winning quote. So we can actually go back to our main project here, and we can actually accept this quote. So we click yes to all these options. Is the quote correct? Do I have a signed order? Is credit approved? Put in the order number. And this order number can also be used, will be seen throughout, will flow right through the system as well. Enter in the date. So let's make it 21. And this is the same as well. And we can accept this quote now. So you can see there the result was empty. Click accept. Quote is accepted. And we can print some details, which we don't need to do. And now that is a winning quote. So if I click on the folder now, I can actually view and see there we have the drawing, we have the quote, and we have the material list. The material list is in the form of a spreadsheet, which the iRent system can actually import. So that folder is part of our filing system. So we can now minimize that. Now we're back to iRent. We're in iRent now. Go to the project screen. You can see here the last quote and project is 1047. Go to import, imported successfully the quote, and there we have our new job that we've just entered in. Click into the project. Now we can do a few different things with the project. So we have the project here. So we have exactly the same details as we entered as the quote, with the customer details, site details, which automatically flows through from iQuote. Click on stages and charges. Then we have our individual stage with its description that I typed in. There's our order number from iQuote. And then we have all our charges that we entered in. This can be invoiced as a contract. So as you can see there, that's our quotation. And then we have the amount to actually invoice. So we can actually invoice it as a contract by clicking on the invoice button. And we can invoice all the different components of the contract. I can choose not to do that. and I can decide to go to job details and invoice it as a item billing. So I can invoice based on individual items if I wanted to. So this project is ready to be delivered to, and so we can look at, click on deliveries and returns. Notice how there it's a new job. Just quickly going back, I want to quickly show you that also the this 1048 is also the quote number here, and we also have a contract number as 1048. But we can change some of these descriptions if we need to. So we go back to stages and charges, which is our main scaffold, and we can go to deliveries and returns. As we can see there, there's our job, and there's our list of deliveries. If we already had some deliveries, this is a new job, so we don't have any deliveries, and we can create a new delivery for this job. All the information is already in there. Just type in the date to be delivered. We can save this, specify the yard we're delivering from, and we can import straight from file. So we know that this is job 1048, and we can import this straight into the system. The integration between iScaf and iRent has some error checking. So if there are items that are in iScaf that are not in iRent, it will give you a warning and will import whatever it can import. This is just a demo, so we deliberately made some of the items not match up so we could show you that little bit of interface there. So the items automatically get populated into the system. You can now save this and print this as a picking slip. And then save it as an official delivery docket by processing it, so it becomes an actual delivery docket now. Of course, we can print tags as well. Now that I'm back here, now I click on Find, we have the delivery docket in there as well. Click Exit, I'm now back to the project. I can actually print a summary of the job balance. So there's our job, there's our job balance, and we can actually report the job balances. All from within the same screen. So this is our very brief overview of the integration between iQuote, iScaf, and iRent.